Initiating moisture.
It's super rare for a game to completely blow me away and catch me by surprise, but that's exactly what happened with this game. It Takes Two is an absolutely stunning, amazing masterpiece of a game. Every single aspect of this game is wonderful. This is a game that clearly had a ton of passion put into it, into every little detail. You can feel the creator's heart and soul in the game universe. I felt like he was reaching out and touching me. Maybe tweaking on my nipples a little bit as I was playing through the game, kissing me all over. This is a game that clearly was a passion project. And you can tell just with like the way that they sell the game, only one person needs to own the game and you can let someone else play with you. This is a co-op game and it's an only co-op game. You can't play this solo. And it is just an incredible journey. It focuses on a husband and wife whose relationship has gone to dog shit and now they're considering a divorce. In fact, they're pulling the trigger on the divorce. And their daughter is extremely sad about it. In her sadness, she accidentally casts a spell, which turns her mom and dad into dolls, and they go on a grand adventure together. It is a moving story. The characters are so well done. For the first half of the game, you're gonna fucking hate the mom and dad, and that's by design. You're supposed to hate these two characters as you're getting going. They're highly unlikable. They do some truly deplorable things, some very fucked up things that I'm not going to get into because I want to spoil even the smallest minute detail of this game. No game in a long time has been able to elicit such emotion from me while playing it. I was finding myself just getting huge ear-to-ear smiles going through it, getting really sad during some things, like some characters that you get introduced to undergo some very brutal things. I mean, there's like a fucking scene here that was like straight out of a goddamn ISIS torture video. Like, it was brutal to watch, and you as the player are the one controlling it. So I mean, there's some nutty shit in here that I, you know, it had me feeling things that I haven't felt in other games, like, ever. Like, this game got me really emotionally attached to the characters and the world. It is so well done. The narrative is so good. The characters so fucking good. There's nothing about this game that is even anything less than amazing and incredible. This is a game that introduces a new mechanic in pretty much every new level. It's not something where you get like, you know, two or three mechanics that are just used ad nauseum throughout the whole game. And this is a long game, by the way. This is like a fucking 14-hour game. It took Matt and I 11 hours and 40 minutes to beat this bad boy. And we were fucking speedrunning it. We have some of the biggest brains in all of the world when it comes to puzzle games. So we were blasting through puzzles and stopping to, of course, appreciate the world and the art. And it still took us 11 hours. This is a big, beefy game. This is a game you can only play co-op. You can't do this solo. So, I mean, grab a friend, grab your significant other, and get ready to go on a fucking moving journey. And if you don't have a friend or a significant other, go on like a rent-a-friend website or something and just get them to fucking play with you because you need to experience the game. Like, this is a one-of-a-kind game. It's made by the same developers as A Way Out, which I enjoyed for what it was, but I didn't think it was anything like this. This game is fucking incredible. Absolutely lovely in all aspects. Now, I also really like the way they market the game, and like by that I mean the way they sell it. Only one person needs to own the game, so if you buy the game, you can get a partner to play with you without them having to own it. Only you need to have it. Only one person needs it, which I think is great. Which shows me they're really not in it for the money. They wanted to deliver a unique and great experience, and that's exactly what they've done. This is a labor of love, and you can really feel it when you play it. Like I was mentioning, this is a game that never runs out of creativity. Every new level, you're getting new mechanics. So, you know, for the first couple of levels, it's mainly some platforming with, you know, some rope swinging here and there. Nothing too wild or out of the park. But then you go to the next level, and you've got two new mechanics to work with. You know, next level, Cody's got a fucking honey blaster gun, and May's got a sniper rifle. And together, when you combine the two, it causes explosions, which you use to solve puzzles. Then you go to the next level. You know, now you're inside of a fucking grandfather clock, where Cody's got a goddamn chronosphere dialing back the clock, turning back time, so you're manipulating time to solve puzzles, and May is able to clone herself. Like, you get all kinds of new creative tools to tackle the puzzles in the game, and it's so good. The game, in the entire runtime, at no point ever slows down and gets stagnant. You are constantly getting new mechanics to play with in a brand new world to play with. Every level is drastically different from the previous one. There's a level where you go inside a fucking tree and you're dealing with squirrels that are war-hungry maniacs, and they're at war with the wasps. Then you're riding beetles around in a fucking wasp hive going wild, trying to save, you know, a bee who's in disguise as a robot. Like, there's just so much going on and constantly changing. You are always enjoying yourself. It is so well thought out and so creative. I can't suck this game's asshole hard enough. I haven't been blown away by a game like this in such a long time, if ever. And the soundtrack complements it wonderfully. The soundtrack bangs so hard. Nothing but boner jam after boner jam. It's so cinematic too, like the cutscenes and the set pieces. I don't want to spoil anything, but it's so fucking cool. It's so good. And there's also mini games throughout the world that you find, and when you find a mini game, you go head to head with your partner, you know, Cody versus May, so you versus whoever you're playing with, and you do these mini games and compete against each other, and the mini games are super fun. You know, there's simple ones like you play chess against each other, then there's more complicated ones that are like a fully fleshed out mini game where you're playing like two battle tanks going to war. Like, it's just so good. It's so fucking good. It Takes Two is one of these rare games where it really feels like they wanted to deliver something that we've never seen before, and I think they've done it. This is a game I've never experienced anything like it before. It's just, it's an absolute joy. I'm gonna plug It Takes Two into the moist meter now. I'm giving it a 95%. I don't have any complaints at all, literally not even the slightest nitpick that I could find with this game. This game is absolutely fucking incredible. Now I know you're wondering, well then why didn't I give it 100%? I've said this before, I reserve 100% for games that I feel anyone of any taste can pick up and fucking fall in love with and, you know, go wild about. And the only game I would ever consider giving 100% to is Minecraft. I'm personally not a huge Minecraft fan, but I actually think it's probably the perfect video game. Anyone of any age and any taste can hop in Minecraft and enjoy the shit out of it. I don't feel the same way about It Takes Two. It Takes Two is going to be someone or some people looking for a narrative experience, a creative world, platforming and puzzle solving. There's a lot of people that are going to be not enjoying the game. I totally understand that. But I really do feel like the game is pretty much flawless. It's just a game that's not going to be for everyone of every taste, which is the only reason I'm not giving it 100%. But this is as close as I've ever come in the history of the moist meter. This game is just, it's so good. Like, if you watched Matt and I stream it, you know on my stream, I was going absolutely wild. Like, I would take every opportunity to suck the fucking soul out of this game's dick. I fell in love with this game. This is a game that I genuinely think I will always think back on with a smile on my face. It's going to be one of those rare games where, like, 50 years from now, I'll still think about from time to time and just be like, yeah, that was a golden age of gaming thanks to It Takes Two coming out that year. Like, shit, the game is, I absolutely loved it. Like, you know, as you can probably tell, I'm a huge fan of it. I really am. And it's not even a genre I really like. Like, platformers, I'm not too big on these days, and still loved it. Still absolutely loved it. So, highly recommend it if you have a friend or a significant other that you could play with. And I really think most people would probably enjoy the game as well. So, that's about it. There's been a golden rule most people follow these days, which is never settle for less when it comes to your mattress. It's something you're going to be using every day for a long, long time, which is why I'm going to talk about Helix mattresses. Helix mattresses are absolutely fantastic. They're catered to your body type. So you take a sleep quiz, which tells them exactly how it is you interact with the mattress, and they match you with the best possible mattress for your body. So for me, I sleep on my back. Sometimes I'd wake up with lower back pain because my mattress was a little too soft, and then taking the sleep quiz, I got matched with a mattress that was a little bit firmer for me, and now I just don't have that lower back pain in the morning anymore. Helix mattresses are super comfortable and just a really, really great option. So if you're looking for a new mattress or just want to upgrade your mattress, you can definitely check out Helix. You can go to the link in the description below to get up to $200 off your Helix mattress, or you can go to helixsleep.com/moist to get up to $200 off of your Helix mattress. So yeah, absolutely give them a try if you want a better mattress. That's it. See ya.